Welcome to session 4 of our DevSecOps series in GitLab. In this session, we'll talk about license compliance and we will introduce you how to enable that in GitLab. So license compliance, again, is a GitLab ultimate feature. It's about managing what licenses are acceptable for your project. And it provides you with visibility of what licenses the libraries you depend on actually use. License compliance in GitLab is implemented as follows. It scans all dependencies in your project and derives the licenses from them. It then checks whether the licenses it found are acceptable for your project. This means whether you marked them as acceptable. It also flags licenses that are not compliant with what you defined is acceptable. To implement all of this, GitLab uses the License Finder open source tool.
So, Paddy, as far as I understood it, we have now introduced the Java application. But why do we need to check the licenses of such a Java application?
Well, similar as with the dependency check we did before, we use a lot of libraries and dependencies for our Java, in this case, Spring Boot application. And each of these libraries comes with its own license. And it's quite hard to figure out what all these licenses are. So it's very valuable to have a tool that tells us what we are actually using. So what licenses are involved, so that we can manage them.
Oh, Paddy, that sounds great. How can I enable that in GitLab?
Well, that's quite simple again. To enable license compliance, we, similar to what we did for the dependency analysis, we enable it in GitLab CI.yaml, so in the main pipeline file. We again have just to add a template, this time licensescanning.gitlab.ci.yaml. So now we are back in our video demo project. We've already built the pipeline for our Spring Boot demo application, and we also introduced and enabled vulnerability scanning. If you want to know the details about that, make sure you watch our previous video sessions on these topics. As we've learned and as we've done in the previous videos, we're editing our pipeline definition file and we're going to add the license compliance scanner here. So I edit and just add another template file that's provided by GitLab and that you can also copy to your own repository to get more control about. I again commit directly to the master branch and let the pipeline run. While GitLab is building our pipeline, let's take a look at the license compliance file in the GitLab repository. As mentioned, you may copy this file and provide it within your own GitLab repository, for example, to make sure that you always use the same version of the license compliance tool. So we are back now in GitLab, where it finished the pipeline for us. We see that it added for us a license scanning job. Now let's see what it tells us. Well, scanning through that, we see that on line 41 here, we see license finder Maven is not installed. Bad luck for us. Looks like the image provided as of kind of producing this image, this video, had a bug. So license finder 4 has a bug where Maven is not accessible. So to fix this bug and basically mark Maven as executable within the image provided by GitLab, we had to add lines 1 to 5 within the pipeline definition 5 file. Basically, this means we said that we'll want to make Maven an executable file. With this fix applied, GitLab started a new pipeline run, and we'll see now that this pipeline run was again successful, but also that finally we have no more error messages on line 41 here, but we are able to execute the license finder tool successfully.
So, Paddy, that's absolutely cool. Now we have executed the license finder, but where can I see the results?
Good point, mate. So the results are found in security and compliance and then license compliance menu. If we open that, GitLab presents us all the licenses it detected, which is quite a lot. We didn't expect to see 5 licenses here.
Wow, there are already 5 licenses that we are already using. But how can I now configure which licenses are allowed and which licenses are denied?
Well, to do this, you can click on policies and then add license policy. Now you can add, for example, the MIT license we found here, and you can allow it. In the meanwhile, I've added 4 licenses as acceptable and 1 license I didn't add. Later on, we will see how GitLab provides us a nice view afterwards of what acceptable licenses we use and which are not acceptable. GitLab also provides us the option to define what users may add additional or may accept licenses that are not yet in the list of allowed licenses. I'll do this next. To do this, I update approvals, add 1 approval, and add the DevSecOps team as acceptable approvers to this list. So everyone in the group Suke DevSecOps can now accept new licenses, which is basically Romano and myself in this case. So I add us as approvers, and we see now that license approvals are now active. The license approvers come only into play when we start working with branches and create merge requests. We'll see that in a later video session. Now that we've assigned the acceptable licenses, see what the pipeline now tells us. I head back to pipelines. I open the last pipeline run, and we now have a licenses tab here. And this one now shows us that we have 4 licenses that we marked as acceptable in our project and 1 license that has not yet been assigned or accepted.
So that was very cool. With just adding 1 line in our pipeline configuration, we were already able to enable license compliance. And with that, we also got a license report. We saw what kind of license we already are using, and we were able to configure which licenses are allowed and which licenses are not allowed.
So thanks for watching. And in the next session, we'll introduce you on how to add static application security testing to your GitLab pipeline.